Blessed be God. Blessed be God for another day. Thank you for the last Sunday in the month of October. Be that glorified, Lord. We worship you in the mighty name of Jesus. So just stay with me. And if you're a pastor or you're a minister, just stay with me to the end of this message. I believe God that he will drop a word that you need at this very time. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, I will be preaching on the topic titled, "These Signs Shall Follow Them." These signs shall follow them. Hallelujah. And my text will be taken from the book of Mark Gospel, chapter 16. Now, this was all the synoptic gospel recorded all the account of Jesus. And I've come, one thing I've discovered that the commandment that Jesus gave to the disciple, they follow it to latter. Mark 16 and verse 14. Mark chapter 16, verse 14. Afterward, he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat, and upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not them which had seen him after he was risen. They didn't believe, because when appeared to Mary Magdalene and they didn't believe. So they said, we want to see him. In verse 15, and he said unto them, go ye into the other world and preach the gospel to every creature. And he that believeth, not the land of war, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. But he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs, that's where I took my topic from. And these signs, not one, these signs shall follow them, shall follow me as a preacher. I believe in my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpent, and if they drink any deadly things, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover. And verse 19 down to 20. So then, after the Lord has spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord walking with them and confirming the word with signs following. Amen. Now, you need to notice something. The book of Matthew down to John, you hear all the last word you could see in all those books are amen. They ended with amen. Amen means let it be so. So the affirmation of what Jesus are giving to them, they are saying we need to walk with it. We put a stamp on it. Hallelujah. Now, the book of the gospel written by apostle recorded some of the miracle Jesus Christ did. The book recorded by the apostle, in fact, excluding even Acts of Apostle. He recorded most of the miracle, because Bible say if the miracle that Jesus Christ did, it were recorded in the Bible, say the old earth will not contain it. And we need to learn and understand that some of the documentary we are written for us to continue to learn and to teach people about this good news. You will notice that the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John ended, like I said, ended with the word amen. That is a big affirmation. We are going to look on the word of God that generated this signs and wonder. You see, this sign shall follow them that believe. Imam, blessed memory, Archbishop Bensi Dawusa, he read the scriptures. These signs shall follow them that believe. And he went to meet the pastor after the close of the service. He said, this is what I'm seeing on the Bible. Do you believe that? I say, yes, I believe. He said, can I do signs and wonder? He said, you can do it. And since that he went out, and signs and wonder began to follow him until he went to glory. When we believe in signs and wonder, I tell you that we could really prove this Jesus that died and rose up again. The sign shall follow them. Now, I have some apology, some pastors who feel that they are not called to preach signs and wonders. Motivational speakers. Signs and wonders should follow everyone that believe that preach the gospels. This gospel or this kingdom is for demonstration of the power of God. Pastor today, they follow, they have more titles than the signs following them. They have more titles. When you look at a man like T.L. Osborne, you don't have a title. Sumi Wugusok, Evan Robert, John Wesley. These men, title didn't follow them, but signs and wonders followed them. Title didn't follow them. Graham Bonnke, R.W. Schambach, A. Allen, and a whole lot of them, Catherine Kuma. They didn't have a long title following their name, but these signs followed them. Today we have a bunch of pastors, a bunch of men of God that they every year their title keep changing from a brother to a pastor, from brother to evangelist, from evangelist to a pastor, from a pastor to an apostle and all that. Now to bishop, then the archbishop. It is not the title that guarantees the signs following us. It is the understanding of the Bible. A man in Nigeria called a blessed memory of called Baba Ayodele Babaola. The man didn't carry heavy title, didn't wear castle cannot, but yes, signs and wonder followed him. These signs shall follow them, I believe. Bring a pastor to your church and you didn't introduce him well, he'll be angry with you. He said, no, you didn't put all my titles. Hallelujah. There was a time I was having the program and I invited a pastor. I didn't invite him anyway. He came to just encourage us. And I said, I was just introducing the pastor who was in the meeting. And I said, Pastor Suso, he was in is here with us today and all that. Then when we closed, he came to me and said, but man of God, you know, the title have changed. I said, what is the title now? He said, I am an apostle. Yet he have no traveled out of his country, have not preached in nations of the world. Titles have made us, have tied us down, make us not to follow the signs and wonder. You see a young man in a shop with 10 members bearing the name Bishop. Bishop in the shop. These signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall lay hand upon the sick and the sick shall recover. Peter didn't have signs and wonders. They didn't have a name, bishop or an apostle or prophet and all that. But yet, the apostle preached and one day, 3,000 souls were added to the church. We need to walk away from title and follow what Jesus said. These signs shall follow them. I remember my younger brother was doing a prison ministry and invited me to preach in one of the big prison in Nigeria. When he invited me there to preach, the church there in the prison was very big. A lot of people, prisoners were there. He said, well, this man, I've known him. He was introducing me. I've known him since I was born, but I have no title to ascribe to him. But when he finished preaching, you can decide to give him any title. You can decide to call him or a prophet or a pastor or an evangelist, whatever title you have here manifested. So we shouldn't put title first. We must remember that this sign shall follow them that believe, not those who carry titles. Are you saying, Pastor, are you against title? No, I'm not against title. But it must not enter our head to the point that we look at the title first, not the war, not the demonstration of the power of God. Call me a brother and I will go for crusade and the lane will jump, begin to jump up and begin to walk. They don't begin to speak and begin to hear. They don't begin to hear. These signs shall follow them. And at times I begin to look, where do you miss it that this sign is not following the church anymore? Churches today, they do more of packaging, more branding, more of decoration than the sign. That you can go to a church, you will not see the move of God. You don't know the difference between church now and a nightclub. These signs shall follow them. I'm going to quickly, in this Sunday's meeting, I'm going to be looking on five major words in our text. Five major words that you could see and work on a five major one. Number one is believe. He said these signs shall follow them that believe. In other words, if you believe, Jesus said, greater work shall ye do, because you have gone to meet his Father. So my question today, do you believe? Do you believe that God can heal you? Do you believe that God can deliver you? Do you believe that God can prosper you? Do you believe that this thing you are going through now, there's going to be an end to it, to expire? This battle you are going through, it will expire one day. These signs shall follow them. I believe. Number one, believe. You cannot preach the gospel with signs and wonder following you without believing in Jesus. We must first of all believe in the name of Jesus. If not, how do you preach to them? Which name are you going to use to preach? Believing is the first step of becoming a Christian. As a matter of fact, when you give your life to Jesus, you believe that he died and rose up again. That's the first step. Believe, you must believe that Christ came, died, and rose up again. Hallelujah. You must have to believe. Number two, he said, in my name, talking about Jesus, in my name shall they cast out devils. So we cannot cast out devils on other person's name, but the name of Jesus. You see, in the name, the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. Both in heaven and in earth, and being earth, they must bow. Every miracle we see today in the body of Christ has a stamp of the name of Jesus. That's why I said the synoptic gospel all of them ended with amen, means a stamp, let it be so. In the name of Jesus, be healed. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. The apostle did that and they saw signs. We can do that as well. I share with us, you know, the testimony of R.O.W. Schambach when he went to India for a crusade. He said he has sent a missionary there for years and the church is not growing, no soul. He said, what is going on? So he went there for a crusade. And the first night he preached, people didn't come to give their life to Christ. The second night, he said, let me just begin to pray for the sick in the name of Jesus. And he said, bring all those who cannot see, who cannot hear, those who cannot walk. They line them on the podium. And I begin to pray for them one by one. In the name of Jesus, get up and walk. In the name of Jesus, get up and walk. And people were just looking. He got to one woman. He said, well, I'm going to prove to you that it is only the name of Jesus that he, not me now, the name of Jesus. And he lay hand upon the woman and said, in the mighty name, I think Muhammad or Buddha in that community where they worship. He said, get up and walk. The woman couldn't walk. They tried to lift the woman up. No, it went back, bam, like a bag of potato. He said, now let me do the work for you. And he went back and lay her and said, in the name of Jesus, woman, get up and walk. All of a sudden, the woman flip up like a robot, stamp, bam, and begin to run up on the places. So in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, it guarantee us miracles. It guarantee us breakthrough. It guarantee us deliverance. So in my name, Jesus, shall they cast out devils. Do you believe in the name of Jesus? There's no other name on earth that which a man could be saved except the name of Jesus. Do you believe it? You that's watching me right, do you believe on the name? I've come to introduce that name to you. That is the name we preach. That is the name we brag of. The name, not the name of a bishop, not the name of a pastor, the name of Jesus. It is greater than any other names. No matter what you are saying, that name of Jesus is greater than any other name. Hallelujah. Number three, our text talk about casting out devils. In my name. Now, there is not say casting out devils. I love it. Now, we don't cast out devils on our names. It's the name of Jesus. Shatakadab. Casting out devil is the authority Jesus Christ, the anointed one, has given to us. Casting out devils is the authority in the name of Jesus are given to us that we, when we say in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, depart or go, a demon leave, and they will leave. Not the name of voodoo. No, we don't cast out devil through magical power, no. When I see people who they do a service and intervene demon for hours, You had that time. You are a man under authority. Tell the demon to go. In the name of Jesus, leave her alone or leave him alone. And there will be peace. Hallelujah. You know, people can say a lot of things and say, but Jesus was speaking to the demon in the swine. No. Check it. After that, what did he hear again? Jesus knew that this, if he go beyond that, it's going to take him, it's like acting a play. And the madman of God say, so have you come to destroy before our time? Because they know that time have not come. Jesus Christ said, no. And Jesus Christ replied, say, who are you? Say, we are legion, because our men tormenting them. So this man, say, go. He didn't ask them, how many of you there? Where are you in the body? How did you enter his body? For which village did you come from? No. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we cast out devils. You see, if this power that raised up Jesus Christ dwells in you, Roman, it shall quicken your mortal bodies. Don't waste time negotiating with the devil. Don't waste time to have any devil. Cast the devil out. Because you have the power, you got the authority to cast the devil. I'm going to show you some group of people who were trying to cast out the devils, but yet they don't know the name of Jesus. I say you need the name of Jesus to cast out devils. We don't imitate deliverance. We don't say because you see a man doing deliverance, then you begin to also do deliverance. Come out, come out, come out in the name of Jesus. No, you need to know Jesus by yourself. Let me show you in Acts of Apostles. I love it. In Acts of Apostles, chapter 19, verse 11, Bible says, talking about upon his ministry of Paul, it says, and God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul. These are not miracles of his. I was feeling headache then, headache. Thank God for that. I was just feeling sad and suddenly joy came. Thank God for that. I was having a pain in my waist, but God just healed me right now. Thank God for that. Well, this is the Bible says special miracle was wrought in the hand of apostle. That they see a man or a woman who was bedridden, say, come on, get up and walk. And the man get up and walk. That you see a man who could not see, could not, who was blind or dumb from death, from bed, and say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, receive your sight. These are special miracles, creative miracles. He said, and God wrote special miracles in the hands of the apostles, so that from his body we are brought unto the sick handkerchief or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirit went out of them. That is casting out devils. When they sense the power of God surrounding Paul, the evil spirit jump out. You cannot stay in the same house with demons. No. Most times when people come close to me who are possessed, they can't look at my face. They begin to scream. You say, no, I don't want to see this man. I don't want to see this man. Because light and darkness does not work together. These signs shall follow them that believe. So when Paul did that, look at what's going to happen now. Verse 13. And certain of the vagabond Jews, extortionists, took upon them to call over that which had had evil spirit. They said, now we saw Paul doing it. We're going to do it again. We're going to also do it. To imitate Paul, whether we can just do it. I had evil spirit. The name of the Lord Jesus Christ, saying, we adjoin you by the Jesus whom Paul preached. So they don't know the Jesus by themselves. We adjoin you, we command you in the name of who Jesus preached, Paul preached. The devil could say, well, anytime. You see, it is not everybody that called the name of Jesus at work. You need to understand, know this Jesus by yourself. Now, why is it? You see, you could bring two people now to perform signs and to cast a devil. One will say, in the name of Jesus, come on, and the demon will just be laughing. But another man will come say, in the name of Jesus, get out! Some of them don't even. You see, I've watched the ministry of A. Allen. When A. Allen looked at the demon possessed, say, I am A. Allen. He knew, they knew, they had he knew that this man carried authority. It's not just a common flag. So when the demon know those who really believe in Jesus, the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus. Look at verse 14. And there were seven sons of one Caiaphas, a Jew and a chief of the priests, which did so. And the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, and Paul I know, but who are you? It's an embarrassment for the devil to ask you, who are you? When I see people doing deliverance on TV and say, asking devil, do you know who I am? That's an insult. The devil should see and scream, no, we cannot stay in this body anymore. I'm going. The devil look at you and they will turn their face. At times when I'm preaching, so during deliverance, not even during deliverance, there was time we were preaching a message, and as I was worshiping, I noticed that one lady was just covering her ear, covering her ear. I said, no, something must happen today. And I begin to call the fire of God. And the lady began to turn without nobody laying hand upon her. And I fell on the floor. And the lady was going like a snake on the floor. Without nobody touching her. Why? The demon in house sense a higher power. The signs shall follow them. I believe. They will say, we are joy to come out. And say, who are you? You see, and the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, Paul I know, but who are you? And the man in whom the evil spirit was leaped on them and overcame them and prevailed against them, and they fled out of the house naked and wounded. The demon taught them lesson. He said to them, I'm going to teach you a lesson. Don't allow the devil to teach you a lesson. If you don't have the signs, if you don't know Jesus, receive Jesus genuinely. All this gospel we are talking about now, no, you don't need to fast and pray, you don't need, can I shock you? There are some pastors today who are preaching the altar, they don't know the road to Calvary, they've not been to Calvary. They have no encounter. Money does not make a good church. You say, no, if you can have money and buy a good place, buy instrument, decorate it, no. You can bring the money, but God is not there. Hallelujah. Now, number four, speaking with new tongues. That the Holy Ghost. I love that. The Holy Ghost. This is the promise of the Father that he promised him. He said, tarry ye in Jerusalem until the power you been due from high. The Bible says in Acts chapter 2, verse 1 down to 4, Bible says the fulfillment came. See, they were all together in one accord. And suddenly, the Holy Ghost came. If you need to do more work, you need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is our machine, it's our battery. That you pray, you are not tired. Yatakata, Ilenko, Parana, Sinako. You see, as a man of God, the Holy Ghost give you boldness because Jesus promised us that. He says, a spirit now go to the Father so that I can send you another comforter like me that will abide in you. Do you believe on the Holy Ghost? Speaking within tongues. Then lastly, laying on hands. I hope you believe on laying on hands. Laying on hands. When we lay hands upon the sick, what we are doing, we will become a medium that will transfer power to them. It's like, let me explain this way. It's like a car that was parked for days and the battery run down. The car has a battery, not that you don't have a battery. But when you go and use the car on the ignition, you will not see power coming out because kickstarting the car. But you need another battery who is really charged to jumpstart that car. That when you connect it, one hand, chakra, it starts. That's laying of hands. When we lay hand of hands, it's not a religious activity. We are transferring power from heaven. We invoke power. We call from power. Download power. Come on, receive. Bible says, for this cause, I bow my knees. Bow your knees and lay hand upon the sick. Anytime I lay hand upon the sick, there's a transfer of power. I was praying for a woman that was bedridden, you know, and as I knelt and lay hand upon her, you could see her, it's like something entered through her. You could see her just turning. All of a sudden, she began to roll. And it started rolling gradually, all of a sudden, it began to roll very fast. And I stood up. All of a sudden, after rolling, he just got up, and a woman who could not walk, begin to run up and down. And they say, there is Jesus. This Jesus is true. These signs shall follow them. I believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. Today, we're going to prove the signs. Hallelujah. We're going to prove the signs. Are you watching right now? And you need deliverance, you need healing, this sign shall follow them. You're going to see the sign right now. This gospel or the kingdom is not by war, it's not by mouth, but it's by demonstration of the power of God. We must demonstrate the power of God. Are you ready? Wherever you are, there's a man, you're having a pain in your chest here, Kasina non. This sign shall follow. See sign. Close your eyes. Let's pray. If you are here, if you don't know Jesus, you must know him first. You must know him. I'm going to say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I need repentance. Have mercy upon me. Wash me clean with your blood. From today, I declare with my mouth and my heart believe that you died and rose up again on the third day. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name. Let me pray for you. Still bow your head down. Father, I thank you and bless your name for this one that taking a decision to follow you. Lord, I am praying that you affirm their confession, write the name in the book of life. In the name of Jesus. Devil, they reject you right now. They belong to Jesus. A new kingdom. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, my God and my Father. In Jesus' name. Now, welcome to the kingdom. Hallelujah. I rejoice with you. And this is actually the reason why we came. I rejoice with you. Now, you that have taken the decision, you're going to see signs and wonders follow you from today. There's going to be a power move in your life. Now, we're going to pray for those who are sick. If you are sick right now, just hold on. Miracles are about to happen. If you are sick right now, miracles are about to happen. If you need deliverance, maybe you cannot sleep at night. There's a demon pressing you down. Today's your freedom. Stretch your hand to the screen, whatever you're watching, either your phone, your iPad, or your computer, or your TV screen. Stretch your hand toward. Let me pray. Kashuna Hansa. Zize Kida Manando. Ligros Nangunda Ratakaya. Kikoto. Barataka. Lord, we call down your power now. There's someone the Lord spoke to me now in this ear. You're not deaf, but most time when you close this ear, that ear, you can't read, you hear so faint. Put your finger on that ear right now. Shiko Tanananusa. Be open, effortile, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, as time, O God, as a servant, O God, sent by you, representing the kingdom of God before your people. Wherever pain, whatever sickness in their body right now, I declare, be healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Sickness cannot stay in that body. In the mighty name of Jesus, every knee must bow. You have a name, you sickness. Wherever sickness it may be, it could be leukemia, it could be sugar diabetes, it could be high blood pressure, it could be sickle cell anemia, it could be any sin, or it could be cancer, it could be HIV. I curse you, depart now in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare you healed. Let the people of God go free. You have no hold over them anymore. In the name of Jesus. Be healed now. Be healed now. Be healed now. In the name of Jesus. Now, if you have a physical things that you could see that your leg is broken or just begin to do what cannot before right now. Miracle is going, creating miracles. Begin to check yourself. Something's happening right now. Something is happening. That is it. Something's happening to that woman right now. Something's happening. Zeto kina nando boti la krehe. Jile konsara kikaba. Thank you for miracles. Thank you for miracle. We believe in miracles, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Shiko suseni and haradu seketis. Blessed be God. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now if you receive a healing, please write to us. Let us, there are numbers, our number are scrolling on the screen. Write to us so that we could know you receive your healing. We're also going to share your testimony. All right? Also in the if you are watching from YouTube or Facebook, you also drop your testimony on the comment section, and we are going to document it. And I trust the Lord, there's going to be a more miracles happening in your life. Not just one miracle, multiple miracles. Congratulations for the miracles. Hallelujah. Now today is the last Sunday of the month, October, and I'm asking you for just drop your offering also in this ministry. If you want to give your offering to this ministry, prayerfully ask the Lord the amount right now you want to give. All right? You can give in any currency of a choice, whatever, regardless where you are. But if you live in South Africa, there's a banking detail in South Africa there. If you live in Nigeria, also part of West Africa, there are banking details, so it's guaranteed through, you can use that. But if you don't live in those regions, you can give in any currency. Through your MasterCard, through your credit card, through your Visa card, just go to our website that appeared on the screen and just go to a place called Donate. Follow the instruction and we'll get your offering. As you receive your offering, I guarantee you that your harvest is now. 24 hours miracles. Father, I bless Ogo as men who are giving online right now. Bless their heart. Bless their works in the name of Jesus Christ. The works of the hands are blessed in the name of Jesus. Your offering is blessed. Your offering is blessed in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise Jesus. Now also, before we sign off, go to Google Play Store or Amazon and get our books. There are some of our books already there. Just look for the title that, or you can even buy all of them and begin to read. As you read, you will experience the same grace, the same anointing that is flowing right now in the name of Jesus Christ. But hear this, no matter what matters, know that the same Jesus is still at work in your life. I'll see you again on Thursday, and I say to you, cha-cha, and God bless you. Shalom.